Hi, and welcome to the Cash Drawer and Currency Organization. Some pictures in this slideshow are intentionally blurred to protect the privacy of customers and business owners. Currency is blurred as well to avoid legal issues. Thanks for your understanding. In this slideshow, you'll learn about the cash drawer, which can be used for storage, which is removable, and which is replaceable. Currency, both rolls of coin and wrappers of paper. Cashier efficiency. Always tell your supervisor when you're running out of currency. Tell your supervisor if you have too much of a type of currency. Put less used items under the cash drawer. Keep paper money face up and facing one direction. Now we'll talk about coin organization. Five change compartments in the cash drawer keep pennies, nickels, dimes, and quarters in their own spots. A fifth bin can hold half dollars or, as shown here, extra rolled coin. Try to keep a coin bin half full of a roll. 25 pennies is half of a 50-cent roll. 20 nickels is half of a $2 roll. 25 dimes is half of a $5 roll. And 20 quarters is half of a $10 roll. The number one rule of cashiering is let your supervisor know before you run out of currency. To quickly open a coin roll, crack it like an egg. Hold 3/4 of the coin roll at an angle over the target bin's metal wall separating two bins. Break the coin roll by slapping the coin roll on the metal wall at an angle, breaking the paper wrapper. The coins will fall into the bin by gravity. Paper money organization. Rectangular compartments at the back of the cash drawer keep paper currency separated into ones, fives, tens, and twenties. The left bin here holds credit slips. Generally, you will be taking in $20 bills and giving back change with ones, fives, and tens. Keep your paper money half full also. Generally, $12 to $13 in ones is half of a $25 wrapper. $50 in fives is half of a $100 wrapper. $100 in tens is half of a $200 wrapper. Alert your supervisor if you get too many bills of one type. Taking money out of the drawer and leaving a credit memo means less cash to be stolen. Keep paper money face up and facing the same way for easy counting. Keep in mind that the cash drawer is removable. Often the cashier will keep $50 bills, $100 bills, credit card receipts, and checks under the drawer. In some stores, you will start with a fresh drawer from a locked safe. In others, you will just take over a register, perhaps logging in with your own unique code. Check with your supervisor for details. If it's not against company policy, give out five $1 bills when making change. This ensures that the customer has $1 bills to donate to the tip jar if they are so inclined. The tip jar may also be a source of $1 bills. Just change them up during a lull in business. Keep larger denomination tips somewhere secure, under the counter perhaps. So, to review, the cash drawer is replaceable, removable, extra storage. Currency is organized by type into coin rolls and paper wrappers, which must be opened for use. Always tell your supervisor when you are running out of currency. Tell your supervisor if you have too much of a type of currency. Put less used and higher value items under the cash drawer for security. Keep paper money face up and facing one direction. So that's it for the cash drawer and currency organization. Now go to www.makingchange.mobi. Register to take the 10-question quiz on the cash drawer and currency organization to demonstrate your mastery of the subject. For job interviews, print a transcript which we can email to you of the courses you've taken and the grades you've gotten. Thanks for the help of Tramway Market, Kingsbury Grade, State Line, Nevada, and Bill Lowe. please send comments, suggestions, or new topic ideas to info@makingchange.mobi. Thanks for viewing the Cash Drawer and Currency Organization, and best of luck out there.